Hello students, welcome to RD Chemistry. In this video, I am going to solve some important top few questions from physical chemistry of second PUC class 12. So let us start now. Yeah, see the first question. In a compound, the atoms of the element Y form the CCP. Let me take Y forming the CCP, cubic close packing. Okay. Let the number of atoms be equal to n. Let there be n number of atoms altogether. Okay, numbers. Okay. Then, element X occupies the 2/3 of the tetrahedral voids. X is present in the tetrahedral voids. But how many are occupied? 2/3 are occupied. Suppose n is the number of atoms of the Y, then tetrahedral will be always double. So, now, only 2/3 is occupied. This should be equal to 4n divided by 3 times. Now take the ratio x is to y ratio. So x is equal to 4n divided by 3 is to y is equal to n. N is the common term there. So 4 divided by 3 is to 1. So now take the simple whole number ratio. This will be, so you have to multiply by 3. This will be 4 is to 3 ratio. Correct? So therefore, it should be x 4, y 3 times, correct? Therefore, answer is option number B. Second one is the answer, clear? Second question, what type of crystal defect is indicated in the diagram below? They are given Schottky defect, Frenkel defect, interstitial and both Frenkel and Schottky defect. Now see here, now some of the ions are missing here. What is missing here? Yeah, sodium ion missing in between. Alternately, sodium and chloride is added. Yeah, what is missing? Sodium is missing, correct? Here, in between sodium, so chloride is missing. In between sodium, chloride is missing. That means, two sodium ions are missing and two chloride ions are missing from their lattice side. Equal number of cations and anions are missing from the lattice side. That is nothing but the Schottky defect. Okay, right? So the answer is B, Schottky defect. Question number 3. A metal has a BCC structure. Edge length is given of the unit cell. That is A is equal to 3.04 angstrom. The volume of the unit cell in terms of cm cube will be. Okay. Now edge length is given. Edge length is equal to 3.04 angstrom units. Now to calculate volume. Volume is nothing but side into side into side. Edge length. Correct. That means A cube you have to do. But finally, answer will be in terms of centimeter cube. Therefore, this A is equal to 3.04 into 1 angstrom is equal to 10 power minus 10 meters, correct? So, it is equal to 3.04 into 10 to the power minus 10. And I want centimeter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, 100 is a 10 power 2 centimeter, correct? So, therefore, this is equal to 3.04 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter. So, we will come back here, volume. So 3.04 cubic, okay, into 10 power minus 8 to the power 3 and centimeter cubic, correct? So this is equal to, this is approximately, now we have got 3 cube, approximately 3 cube I will take, okay? So 3 cube, 3 into 3 into 3, 27 approximately into 10 power minus 24, 8 into 3 is 24 centimeter cube, okay? But this answer directly doesn't exist, we'll change it into scientific notation, so I can write 0.7 into 10 power, okay, that means 27, right, into 10 power minus 24, which will be equal to 2.7 into 10 power minus 23 in terms of centimeter cube, correct? So the answer is option number B, the closest answer, right? Right. Question number 4. In a mixture of A and B, components show negative deviation when? Now, suppose I have got A and B. Suppose A and B interactions are stronger interactions. Attractive forces are stronger. Okay. Compared to AB-AB interactions. Sorry, AB-AB interaction or BB interactions. So what will happen? When attractions are more, molecules come closer. When molecule come closer, volume decreases. Delta V mixing should be less than zero. Delta H mixing, enthalpy change should be less than zero. Correct? Right? So the correct answer for this is matching is option number A, correct? AB interaction stronger than that of AA and BIM interaction. This is for the positive deviation, okay? And B and C for positive deviation, again, okay, greater than 0. And delta V mixing is 0 for ideal solution. So we have got non-ideal positive deviation, non-ideal negative deviation, and this is for the positive deviation again, right? So answer is option number A, clear? Next question. Two solutions of substance non-electrolyte which do not dissociate mixed in the following manner: 480 ml of 1.5 molar, 520 ml of 1.2 second solution. What is the molarity of the mixture? So how to calculate molarity of the mixture is always equal to, with the use of formula, M1V1 plus M2V2. This for the two solution. Suppose the third solution M3V3. So divided by total volume V1 plus V2 it will be. Okay. So it is equal to, so it is a 480 ml into 1.5 molar. Second solution 520 ml into 1.2 molar. Total is volume 480 plus 520. That will be equal to, actually this is equal to 1000. Okay. So when you multiply all these and divide by 1000, which will be equal to 1.344 will be the answer. Okay. So therefore answer is option number 4. Clear? Question number 6. 5.25% solution of substance isotonic with the 1.5% solution of the urea. Okay. Molar mass of urea is given in the same solvent. Let it be water. Density of the both the solution is seen to be equal to 1 g/cm³. You know that water has got density 1.0. Okay. Molar mass of the unknown substance. So what do you mean isotonic solution? Isotonic solution means that the two solutions have the same osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure of the unknown solution should be equal to osmotic pressure of urea. Now, when will be the osmotic pressure same? When the concentration same. When the concentration same. So concentration X should be equal to concentration urea. Now here, what is concentration? Concentration in this case is molarity. So this is the property, colligative property of the osmotic pressure. Now to calculate molarity, molarity is equal to number of moles, correct, divided by volume in terms of liter. Now see there, they are given percentage. Now this is nothing but it is a 5.25 grams per 100 ml always. Other one is 1.5 gram per 100 ml. Volume is same. So I need not worry about the volume. So what I'll do now, number of moles of the X is equal to number of moles of the urea I'll take. So that volume in terms of liter will get cancelled. Common term on both the side. But I will calculate number of moles given mass divided by molar mass. So we'll be taking 100 out of hundreds. So given mass for the first one, 5.25 divided by molar mass unknown, we have to calculate. Let it be MX. That of urea, 1.5 gram dissolved in 100 ml divided by 60. So this molar mass MX will be equal to, so now we'll have to cross multiply. So MX, so this is a 5.25 into 60 divided by 1.5, and this will be equal to 210 gram per mole it is. Okay. Therefore answer is option number C. Clear? Right? Yeah. Next question on mixing heptane and octane to form the ideal solution. Let me take the two component. Heptane, let it be for component number one. Octane, let it be component number two. Two components are there to form ideal solution. Okay. So it forms the ideal solution. Therefore, you have to remember immediately the Raoult's law. Okay. Raoult's law. At 373 Kelvin, vapor pressure of two liquids components are heptane, octane are 105 and 45 respectively. Vapor pressure of the solution to calculate. Total vapor pressure, because after mixing the total pressure. Mixing 25 grams of heptane and 35 grams of octane, and molar mass heptane and octane are given. So you know that according to the Raoult's law, Pt is equal to, okay, P1 naught X1 plus P2 naught X2, correct? First component and the second component, correct? So it is equal to P1 naught. First component is heptane I'll take. So it's a vapor pressure given 105 kilopascal into X1 you need to calculate. Plus for P2, the vapor pressure in the pure state is a 45, that of the X2 you have to calculate. Okay, right? So how to calculate now? Mole fractions. First of all, you need to calculate number of moles of the first one and number of moles of the second one. First one is the heptane, number of moles given mass 25 divided by molar mass 100. So this is equal to 1 by 4, right? 1 by 4 means 0.25, correct? Similarly, N2 is equal to given mass, 35 they're given, divided by 144. This also approximately 0.25. We can do the calculation. We can approximate it because see to that in the options, answers are not very close to each other. How to calculate mole fraction? Mole fraction is equal to N1 divided by N1 plus N2, correct? Here, mole fraction second one is equal to N2 divided by N1 plus N2, correct? So it is 105 into N1 is 0.25 and 0.25, 0.25 add it. So 0.5 becomes. So plus 45, second one is also 0.25 divided by, add the two numbers. So it is equal to 105 into, this is 1 divided by 2, correct? Plus 45 into, this is 1 divided by 2, which is equal to 105 divided by 2. 5 is 2 is 52.5 plus other one is 45.45 by 2, which will be 2 2 is 0.5. And when you add up this one, so we are going to get 75 final answer we are going to get, okay, when you add these two, right? So therefore answer is option number D. Clear? The next question is E0 SRP values are given of 3 electrode ABC respectively, okay? Some numbers are given here. So reducing powers of these metals are, now remember, when the SRP value is negative or very low, this is a very good reducing agent. So reducing power is more, very good reducing agent. And as the SRP value goes on increases, that means they become more and more oxidizing in nature. So the very negative value is for which one? Middle one, B. So it is a minus 3.0 volt. Next one is minus 1.2 volt. Next minimum number, that is a C. And the positive number is which one? So positive number for A, that is A, and that is equal to plus 0.5 becomes, correct? So lower the SRP value, better is the reducing agent. Okay, so this is the pattern BCA respectively. So option number C, clear? Question number 9. Involving a 2 electron chain for the cell reaction, N is equal to atomic use of. And E0 cell is given. E0 is equal to 0.295 volt given. Equilibrium constant Kc we are supposed to calculate at the same temperature. So what is the relationship between equilibrium constant E0 cell? So we have got E0 cell is equal to 0.0591 divided by N. Then log Kc we have got, correct? So E0 cell is equal to 0.295 into N. I'll cross multiply directly now into 2 times. Divided by, I'll do here only, all the calculations, 0.0591 is equal to log Kc, correct? Now, this log Kc is equal to now, so this is equal to 0.591 comes approximately, let me do approximately, divided by 0.0591, okay, right? So, this is equal to log Kc is equal to 10, I'll take, okay, this is 10 to the power 1. Now, at K, find out K. Kc is equal to anti-log of 10.00 approximation because the answers are not close to each other. Now, before, yeah, whatever number is there before the decimal point, that becomes always 10 to the power 10. Suppose you are 11.0, 10 power 11. If you suppose it 12.0, 10 power 12 it becomes. Then, remember, okay, log 1 is equal to 0. So, if I do the reverse way around, log 0 is equal to 1, ulta. So that means Kc is equal to, that means you are going to take your anti-log of 0.00, that is equal to 1. So there is nothing but 10 power 10 itself. The answer is option number C. Clear? Right? Next one, question number 11. Limiting molar conductivities of lambda m0 for sodium chloride, KBr, KCl given 126, 152 and 150 respectively. For sodium bromide, calculate. Suppose you want to calculate the lambda 0 for the given electrolyte, values is not known, then we can make the Kolrost law. We can make the Kolrost law. We can make the Kolrost law. Okay. So suppose I want to find out for the sodium bromide, I don't know. But sodium ions and bromide ions are there. But I know the values of sodium chloride, sodium plus and Cl minus, because when in water, when they dissociate, it gives sodium and chloride ion. Then KCl is there. K plus and Cl minus, correct? Then we have got Sorry, KBr. Second one is KBr. And last one, you have K plus and Cl minus, correct? Now, I should get, by adding and deducting, I should get Na plus Br minus. See here, I require sodium ion. So, I require sodium ion, so let it be plus for this electrode, sodium chloride, okay? I want to bromide. I want bromide. So, bromide is here. So, make the plus. And minus you make it, because so that plus positive, plus potassium, minus potassium get cancelled. Okay, unknown one, yeah, then chloride, plus chloride, minus chloride get cancelled, correct? So what will remain there? Only sodium and bromide will remain. So this is the manipulation in the Kolrosch law. So sodium chloride value is given, 126 they are given, plus potassium bromide value is given, 152 they are given, minus KCl value is given, 150 they are given, is equal to, this is 126, plus 152 minus 150, 280s. So, add these two number, 128, okay, unit remain the same. So, the answer is 128 Simon centimeter square per mole. Clear? Right? Easy. Question number 11. Rate law between A and B given by the formula. So, let me write here, rate is equal to K into concentration to the power N. N stand for order of the reaction. B to the power m, m stand for order reaction, total order is equal to n plus m according to this one, okay. Now, concentration of A is a doubled, they are telling, and concentration B is exactly made half, halving, half of it, okay. Ratio between the new rate and the earlier rate, when the concentration changes, rate of the reaction changes, but the rate constant always remains the same. So, let me make it a new rate, let it be rate 1 is equal to K is always a constant. Now double 2 times A to the power N and exactly make the half of B, halving the B, 1B by 2 to the power N, okay. So this rate will be equal to K, 2 to the power N it becomes concentration A to the power N, then B to the power M into 1 by 2 to the power M it is, correct. So let it be equation number 2, initial let it be equation number 1. So, what you can is 2 divided by 1 we can do. So, rate, okay, second rate, yeah, rate 1 divided by initial rate, let it be. So, when you take the ratios, K and K get cancelled, A and A bar get cancelled, B and B get cancelled. So, 2 to the power N into 1 by 2 to the power M will remain. So, this can be rewritten as 2 to the power N divided by 2 to the power M, which is equal to 2 to the power n minus m can be, okay. So, that how many time increases will be equal to this much. The change will be 2 to the power n minus 1. D is the answer, okay. Question number 12. First order reaction, concentration of, decreases from 0.8 molar to 0.4 molar in the time interval 15 minutes. Now, you see carefully, this is the initial concentration R naught and this is the concentration after 15 minutes, okay. So, this is the concentration R at time T, okay, after 15 minutes, which is equal to actually exactly half of the initial one. That means whatever time is taken, this is called a T, 50% half-life period, where the initial concentration becomes exactly half. Now, question is, 0.1 molar is there. This should become 0.025 molar. What will be the time taken? Now, this is what? This is the first order reaction. Half-life is always a constant, whether you change the concentration or not. Okay, so that means 0.1 molar, you make exactly up. When you make exactly up, 0.05, correct? Again, this one you make exactly up, 0.025 molar, correct? Right? Now, exactly up. So, this is equal to 15 minutes and from here to here, again 15 minutes, okay. So, remember, the half-life value does not change on changing concentration. It is a fixed for the first order reaction. So, 15 plus 15 altogether makes 30 minutes. You have to add these two, that makes 30 minutes to become 0.025. Therefore, answer is option number C. Clear? Next question, interesting question. It is also related to the equilibrium chapter. Following mechanism proposed between NO and Br2. Okay. So, we have to calculate. Second is the rate determining step, RDS, and first we need the equilibrium step, correct? No? Okay, order with respect to N, we have to calculate. Now, when you add these two, say intermediate NOBR to get cancelled. So, the reaction, actual reaction is the NO to NO adding after adding two equation BR2 to give 2 times NOBR, correct? That means I should write down rate is equal to something K into NO to the power X. We don't know order of the reaction, okay? It determined experimentally into BR2 to the power Y. And they're asking us to calculate what is X here, okay? Suppose I take the rate determining, rate of the reaction determine the slowest step, rate determining step. So according to that one, I should write down, okay, K into NOBR2 into NO concentration, okay? Finally, see to that, when you are writing log mass action, you should involve only the actual reactor NO and BR2, not the intermediate. This is the intermediate which is getting cancelled actually. Intermediate doesn't come in the main reaction, okay? So I should replace somehow. So let me write down to the power A and to the power B, okay, for this reaction. But I don't know what is the NOBR2. So I can get it from the equation, first equation, equilibrium. Let it be K equilibrium, outer equilibrium constant, product concentration divided by the reactant concentration, NO and BR2, correct? So I can write down now unknown NOBR2, intermediate concentration is equal to, so that equilibrium constant into NO and BR2, correct? So that you substitute here now, okay? That we are going to substitute here. Some constant K as it is. NOBR2 is equal to that constant equilibrium into NO and BR2. Again from here, NO to the power, okay? Correct? So since these are rate determining equation, number of moles are 1, number of moles are 1, let me take to the power 1 and to the power 1, okay? Because this is an elemental equation, number of moles are 1 and 1 each, 1 molecule each. So we'll be writing now NOBR2 and NO and BR2 and again NO I'll write on, NO I'll write on. So finally, I should write on this rate is equal to these two rate constant, I'll take it as one more K into NO square now. And now it becomes BR2 to the power 1. Therefore, the order with respect to NO will be equal to 2, correct? So order with respect to NO is 2, order with respect to BR2 is 1, total order, total is equal to 3. But question is with respect to NO. So the answer is option number C. So order with respect to NO is 2. Clear? Yeah, one of the important question here also to find out the order of the reaction, they'll give the data here. Okay, see the reaction given here and we have to find out the order of the reaction. Okay, finally, order of the reaction means you are supposed to get order of the reaction, then, okay, rate equation they are given in terms of differential equation. See here, if I write rate for this equation, rate is equal to some K, correct? Into concentration, we don't know to the power X, we don't know the power to the power Y, correct? Something you have to write up. So according to the first equation, if I start, rate is given. This is the rate, this is the concentration A, this is the concentration B. So let me take first equation. So let me write rate 1.2 into 10 power minus 3 is equal to K. What is the concentration A? First data, 0.1 to the power X. B, 0.1 to the power Y. Second data, 1.2 into 10 power minus 3 rate is equal to K constant. Concentration of A is 0.1 to the power X. B is equal to 0.2 to the power Y. Correct? Third data, rate is equal to 2.4 into 10 power minus 3 is equal to K. Concentration is 0.2 to the power X and B is 0.1 to the power Y. Correct? Yeah. So let me scroll down. So what I'll do now, I'll be taking equation number 2 divided by equation number 1. If I do so, correct? See carefully, 2 divided by 1. The rates are same. So that ratio is equal to 1. KK get cancelled. 0.1, 0.1 get cancelled. So remaining is a 0.2 divided by 0.1 to the power y remains, which is equal to 1 is equal to 2 to the power y. Now, I'll take the base same. 2 to the power 0 is equal to 1, which is equal to 2 to the power y. Correct? 1 is the same. That means y is equal to 0. order with respect to B is 0. So B should not come in the picture of the rate equation. Right? Clear? Now, let me go for equation number 3 divided by, now Y should get cancelled. So divided by 1 will make 3 divided by 1. So it is a 1.2 becoming 2.4, correct? Rate will be doubling. K get cancelled. Okay? Then 0.1 to the power Y get cancelled. See carefully. So then remaining is a 0.2 divided by 0.1 to the power X, which is equal to 2, is equal to 2 to the power X, which is nothing but 2 to the power 1 is equal to 2 to the power X. Therefore, X is equal to 1. Suppose I want to write the rate again back. Rate is equal to constant K into concentration A. X is equal to how much? 1. Constant B to the power, Y is how much? 0. That means independent of B. So, rate should be equal to K into A to the power 1. A is the answer. Okay? Clear? B to the power 0 means 1. Okay? Clear? The last physical chemistry topic in the second B syllabus is the surface chemistry. We are in the surface chemistry now. Tyndall effect in a colloidal solution is, what is Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect means we can see the scattering of light due to the collisions, okay, between the particles. So answer is option number A, scattering of light. Question number 2, which of the following is not true for physics option? Physics option, okay, physical adsorption. It is reversible, correct? Because they are adsorbed to the solid surface, the molecules are adsorbed to the solid surface by weak van der Waals force of attraction. They can be easily reversed, correct? It forms multi-layer, correct? As the pressure increases, okay, more and more molecules are attracted due to the van der Waal interaction. This is also correct. It needs activation energy, okay? It needs a low activation energy, should I have given here, lower I. It does not require much activation energy, which is wrong. It is not true. It does not require much activation energy. It increases with the increase in pressure, correct? Increase pressure means as the pressure increases, more and more molecules are adsorbed on the solid surface. So, answer should be, here in this case, answer should be option number C. Does not require much activation energy. It requires very low activation energy. Much activation required for chemist option. For chemist option, large amount of activation energy EA is required. Okay. 17th question, the last question. Colloidal particles in the soap salt carry. Straightforward question. So, soap particle we read like this. So, there is a hydrophobic end and hydrophilic, the negative end. And generally, soaps are the sodium salt of the sulfonic acid. So, if you write sulfonic, SO3 minus. Okay. So, this will be the largest particle, soap particle. So, it is a negatively charged particle. Okay. So, the answer is option number A. If you are watching for the first time, please do like, share and subscribe RD Chemistry and support me. Thank you. Have a nice day.